welcome back to the Woolly Wolverine podcast. This is episode 8. Can't believe we've actually gotten this far. I can't believe I've done this 8 times. Well, I've probably done it more than that in reality, as I have had to stop and start and re-record things. But yeah, episode 8, here we are. So this is a knitting podcast hosted by me. My name is Laura and I live in Kildare, which is in Ireland. And this is a podcast all about knitting. Today's date is the 12th of March 2017. That is crazy. So you can find me on Instagram as at Woolly Wolverine. You can find me on Ravelry as Wolverine, and you can find the show notes for this podcast or anything that I talk about will be in there. You can find that at woollywolverine.wordpress.com. You can find there's a group for this podcast as well, and you can find that on Ravelry at Woolly Wolverine podcast. Sorry, I was just getting distracted. So the light here is supremely bright today. I think I kind of look like I look like a ghost or something like that. I'm very pale. But it is, I'm sitting in front of a window and there's a lot of light, but the clouds are kind of coming along now, so it's going to get a bit darker. So the light will probably change. I got this area again because my family have just gone out, and I said better record quickly because the light here is much better than it is in my bedroom. So I suppose we'll get down to the knitting. So I have no finished objects this week. I had a very busy week work wise and I just had a lot of stuff going on, so I didn't get anything finished. But I have made some progress on some objects. There is a pair of socks which you're probably sick to death of seeing, which is the Love Along socks. If you're a returning viewer, if you're a new viewer, by the way, welcome, and I hope you enjoy what I'm about to show you. So these are the Love Along socks, which is a pattern by Amy Meeks, and here is the progress. So I think last week I was just about at the heel. And oh boy, did these heels give me some trouble. It was my first time doing a heel flap and gusset. Looks quite pretty, I'll give you that, it's nice. And this is Fine Fish Yarns in her Strawberry Shortcake, and blue, I think it was actually labeled as blue, it is quite purple. It was like a duo set. But this heel, yeah, I think the pattern I really enjoy, and it was really well laid out and well, it was described really well how to do the heel. So I think I did the flap fine, that was no problem, and then I went to turn the heel, which was okay, all good. But then I think it was two at a time that kind of confused me as well. So I think I should have picked up the gusset stitches on this side before I moved on to the second heel. But I didn't. So I picked up the gusset stitches on this side when I finished this heel and worked the front. And then when I came back over this side, I was just confused by the pattern, and I said, well, I should probably have gusset stitches here already. I don't know how to pick them up. My yarn management was all over the place. So I moved this sock onto DPNs and figured out the first couple of rounds of joining back in the round, and then move them back onto Magic Loop. So because I had to rip back a few times, and yeah, this heel just kind of, I think I will like how it turned out. It's nice and sturdy, I think, and I like this square heel. I think it looks quite nice and neat. Yeah, I do like it. It's just and now I know how to do it, I think I'll be able to do it a lot easier. But I found it tough. And because of that, I wasn't too motivated to knit on these. I love the yarn, I love the pattern, I just needed a break. So that's all I got done of them. But hopefully I have to do another 4 or 5 repeats of the kind of lace section, and then I will be able to move on to the toe, and then they'll be cast off and I'll have a pair of socks. It's actually getting to that point, which will be the hard part. So hopefully, fingers crossed, everybody, that these will be a finished object next week in my little Bobbins bag, which is just a joy. So this makes everything worthwhile. So because them socks were giving me such a hard time, I did want to cast on a another pair of socks that I could just knit mindlessly on the bus, because I didn't want to look at the Love Along socks. So I cast on a pair of Hermione Everyday socks, which is an Erica Luder pattern. I think it's a free pattern on Ravelry, you can find it. It's a very popular sock pattern, so I'm sure you have seen it. But I've only literally cast these on, so it's I've done the cuff and a couple repeats of the pattern. Just kind of a textured sock. I seem to be doing a lot of pink and purple. I'm not really even a pink person, but yeah, I seem to be doing a lot of pink. So this is Drops Fable, pink, and then the the Silver Fox, which was left over from Dave's birthday socks. So I have loads of this left over, so I said I'd mix myself a pair of socks so we can kind of match. He had blue, I have pink. Boys and girls. Stereotypical. But that's the only, they're my kind of March socks, so hopefully I get these done. Hopefully I get them done before the end of March. That's the goal, but we'll see. The light is really weird because the sun is coming in and out of clouds. The joys of Ireland weather, people. So as well as that, then I wanted to cast on all the things. So I started on Dave's sister's hat in my Amber Maker's Haven project bag, which I love. It's Harry Potter inspired. I've showed it before. And I literally just cast this on. So it's the same. I've showed a hat last week and the week before. It's just a 2x2 rib. Move it into the sun. So I've done, I think, four rounds. 2x2 rib. Made a little bit smaller because mine's a little bit loose. And I'm knitting that in the Drops Alaska in black, which is colours 6, it says here. But it's just black. So that is one of my other works in progress. And then my final one is my Dave the Deer cushion cover. So I think I showed this last week. I'd started it and I made a little bit of progress on it. So this is a pattern by Ruby and the Foxes, and it is uses intarsia. So you can see that there, there's the deer. So you can see that's where it was last week. So I've made a good bit of progress. It's stockinette, so it's twisting like nobody's business. But that looks pretty cool. Yay, deer. So some of the stitches kind of at the edges where you do the twist, or need a little bit of tweaking, but I think it's kind of just a matter of kind of pulling them where you need to, and that will kind of, once I block it, then it'll even out. And all the twisting, don't even look at the back, it is a nightmare back here. Ends everywhere. So I'll tidy that up once we're done, but I've made a good bit of progress. So I was down here. Oh, this is my Cheshire Cat stitch marker, my progress keeper, so cute. I have a set of Alice in Wonderland stitch markers and progress keepers from Copo UK, I think, Copo. I have I'll link her shop and I will show you the rest of the stitch markers now. But this is Dave the Deer. The cream is Signet DK Superwash, in cream, and then this darker purple is also Signet in shade 2999, I think it is. It's just purple. And then these three here are UK Superfine Alpaca in DK weight as well. So this is Lunar Grey, this is Lilac, and this is Damson. And I really like how this is working up. So this is going to be a cushion cover. So I think I have, I'm more than halfway through. Just about to get to the antlers. There's the top of his head there. So we're just about to get to the antlers, and then we'll do probably about the same amount of just stockinette, and then it'll fold and sew it up along the edges. So this could well be a finished object next week as well, but I'm really happy with how this is working up. I think the colours are quite nice and it'll go well in my room. So as I was saying, them stitch markers are by Copo UK. Sorry if I'm saying that wrong, but I will link it down below. So it's a set of Alice in Wonderland stitch markers. So I'll show you some here. So there's a little little teapot. Cute. There's a white rabbit. Well, not white, but there's a little rabbit. Quite cute. There is a lock and a key. Oh, lock and a key. A heart and a crown, kind of for the Queen of Hearts, I'd imagine. I love Alice in Wonderland. I think it's because I dress up as her for Halloween, because blonde hair, that's an easy enough costume. A little bow, but yeah, no, I love her. And then a little sign here that says drink me, little tag. It says drink me, I think you can see that. But they're so cute, I love them. And she has lovely stitch markers in her shop, so I will link you to them in my show notes. So that's all my whips and the progress on them. Not too bad, if I do say so myself. So I'll just move on to the chatter section. So I've had a super, super busy week. So the chatter section does include a small bit of acquisitions, even though it probably shouldn't, because I promised I wouldn't. But I did. So I didn't mention any of my needles. I just remembered, but I'll have them all linked down below. I only remembered because on Sunday last week, myself and Dave went into Dublin, and we went to my local, well, I suppose it's local enough to me, yarn store, which is called This Is Knit, and it's in the it is in the Paris Court Town Centre, which is a kind of a boutique-y kind of shopping centre. There's lots of different boutiques with different types of jewellery and homeware. There's a bridal boutique. There's an amazing cafe right outside This Is Knit called The Pepper Pot, which is amazing. So if you're ever in Dublin and you're looking for a yarn store, you should definitely check out This Is Knit. Their selection is amazing. And hop into The Pepper Pot. Yeah, it's literally step outside. Yeah, This Is Knit, and The Pepper Pot is there, and get yourself. My favourite is a bacon and pear sandwich. My God, delicious. Nice big cup of tea, maybe a scone if you want to treat yourself. Lovely. So we went up to Dublin just to go for lunch and to the cinema. But Dave said we were supposed to go to The Pepper Pot, because Dave loves it, and then I always, well, I don't always pop into This Knit, but that was the plan. But we actually decided to go somewhere else for lunch, and he let me go to the yarn store anyway. So I went into This Is Knit because I wanted to pick up some needles. So I picked some more sock needles. So I picked up a pair of Knit Pro Zing, a 2.5mm, 100cm. Needles, and that's what my Hermione socks are on actually at the moment. And yeah, I may have picked up a skein of yarn, which I have to show you. I don't think I actually have with me here, so I'm just gonna pause this for one moment and go get it because I have to show you because it's amazing. One sec. And we're back. So as I was saying, I was in This Is Knit, which is one of my local yarn stores, and they carry hedgehog fibers, which I have yet to have the pleasure to own. So I couldn't resist when I seen that they had some in stock. So I got this lovely skein. Look at this, isn't it? It's just, it screams Easter to me. There, it's really good. It's pistachio in the sock yarn, and it is 90/10 superwash merino nylon. And it's kind of this minty green and very light purpley pink, kind of orangey rusty speckles. It's phenomenal, and it's so squishy and plump. It's actually very fine, at the same time, which is unusual. I know people have said, I've heard people saying that hedgehog fibers is quite fine sock yarn. And I would agree. So these are going to be socks for me, but I don't want to rush into it, and I want to find a nice contrasting heel tone cuff. So I'm thinking maybe something fuchsia, like something quite bright to lift this, but I love it. So they caked it up for me. So I don't have it in the skein to show you, but yeah, love it. So that was a little treat, and Dave said because it was our anniversary. Well, he didn't actually say because it was our anniversary, but I'm assuming it was because it was our anniversary that he let me break my yarn diet and buy myself a little treat. Treat yourself. So as I said, we went to the yarn store on Sunday. And also, we went for lunch. So we love this place called Bunsen. If you're ever in Dublin, you should definitely go. They do burgers, and that's all. So I have their menu here in my hand. This is their menu. So they've got three locations in Dublin, and that's the menu there. So you can get like, your hamburger, a double hamburger, or a double cheeseburger, a single cheeseburger, fries, sweet potato fries, or soda or milkshake, and they're the toppings that you can get on your burger. Straight up burgers, I believe. Yeah, that's all they do. Straight up burgers. They are delicious. So there's three locations in Dublin. So if you're a burger fan, definitely go. They're generally quite busy. But they're worth the wait. So if you are there and it is full, you can do takeaway, I think, as well, but, or you can sit in, but it's not fancy, but it's so good. Really recommend it. So then as well as that, we went to the cinema. I'm just gonna take a drink because my mouth is like the Sahara Desert. So we went to cinema and we saw Logan. So, which is the new Wolverine film, which is actually, it's rated 16, and I can see why. It is super violent. I really enjoyed it. And when you think about it, it's a man who has knives that come out of his hands. So I can see why it's violent and why they should have gone that way probably from the start of these films. But it is super violent. So that's not your thing, don't go see it. But it is very good. Myself and Dave really enjoyed it. There was a man and his son sitting near us, and the cinema attendant kind of came up before the film had started, and we're having a bit of a chat with them, and eventually the man and the younger boy, I'd say it's probably about 11 or 12, left. And at the time I was like, oh, it can't be that bad. It's a superhero film, but it was that bad. Within like 2 minutes of the start, it's like, oh my god. I wouldn't be one for a lot of violence, but I did really enjoy it. So I went to see Logan on Sunday. So that was a really nice day we had, which was good because I had a super, super busy week in work. I had just had a lot going on, and every day it felt like there was something big that I had to focus on. I didn't get much knitting time. I have made a bit of progress, but I didn't get as much knitting time as I'd like in the evenings because I was preparing, not really preparing, but thinking about the next day. So on Friday, there's a choir in work, which I'm a member of. I love singing. I sing all the time. Me and my mother around the house sing all the time, which drives my dad mad. He calls it out of control singing. He doesn't mind if we're on a stage or if there's a reason for us to be singing, but if we randomly are walking around the house singing, he doesn't like it. But anyway, there's a choir in work, which I'm a member of, and we were singing for there was some event on in work that we were performing at. So I had to, I had a solo, which I had only gotten the day before. So I forgot the words and I had to make words up, but there was people from my floor in the building in the actual at the event, and when I came back to the floor after, they all started clapping and it was very embarrassing, and I wanted the world to open up and swallow me whole, which it didn't, as I'm still here. But yeah, it was a very busy week in work. Hopefully this week will be a bit quieter. St. Patrick's Day on Friday, so we'll have that off. My two little cousins are getting christened on Sunday, so next week, so I won't be able to record next week, but I'll try and record on Saturday. If I don't, it'll be the following week, I'm afraid. And yeah, was there anything else? Oh, yesterday I went to the cinema again with Dave, and we went to see Kong. Skull Island, I think it's called. I'd actually seen it with my dad and my sister on Thursday as well, so I'd seen it twice. Yeah, it's hit and miss. I wouldn't love it. I can't really explain what it is about it that I don't like. I found it very cheesy. It wasn't very realistic. It's a giant monkey. But it wasn't very serious, like it was a bit tongue-in-cheek, and some of the characters were a bit too hammy. I can't really explain it, but I'd say it was probably 5.5, 6 out of 10. Like, it was quite mindless. If you're just looking to go switch off, it's not the worst film to do that. But I definitely would, I'd give Logan an 8. I think the ending was a bit abrupt, but other than that, it was very good and I did enjoy it. But yes, that I think is it for the week. I will try record on Saturday, but if I don't manage to do that, I will see you all in 2 weeks' time. But until I see you again, happy knitting and have a great week. Bye. So this is my kitty, this is little Neo. Say hi, pal. Say hello. He's a little old man now. But he's about 14 years old. And he spends all of his time just sitting here, curled up. Snoozy, don't you, Neo? Except at 5 in the morning when he likes to howl the house down to get outside. Yeah. Yeah, don't you? I talk to him like he's a human and like he's going to answer me. But I think all kind of cat owners do that. Don't we? Yeah. Oh, good boy. What a good boy. Yeah. Well, this is Neo. He's named after the character from The Matrix, which was a film I loved when I got him. He's a lovely man. Good fella. He gets a bit grumpy. He doesn't really like claws.
He doesn't really like sitting on people's laps. He does like a little bit of affection every now and then, but he'll swat you away when he doesn't want you to hang around much more. And he is sleepy here. That's Neil. Say bye bye. Say bye bye. Say bye bye. Okay.